If you always do what you've always done, you'll always be what you've always been. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's audio, we have 5 personal development tips that will help you improve your life. Enjoy.
My first tip for you guys is to start waking up earlier than you need to. And I know some people might be thinking, oh, I'm just not a morning person, but I promise if you get yourself into a routine, it will just become habit and you'll feel so much better. So the biggest reason that you need to start waking up earlier in the morning if you want to be self-motivated, more productive, and just generally feel better is because as humans, we are pretty much programmed into this lifestyle where, you know, you set your alarm to be pretty much like the last moment that you can possibly wake up to do what you need to do. And by doing that over and over again, you're waking up and you're starting off your day being stressed. You're just putting yourself into a situation of chaos, and you're not starting off your day in a way that's making you feel fulfilled, motivated, positive, anything that's good for you. You're starting off pretty much in the exact opposite way. You're waking up, you're eating breakfast as fast as you can, maybe skipping breakfast, you know, showering as fast as you can, doing whatever you gotta do, and you're just so stressed out that by the time you get to where you need to be or do what you gotta do, you are just not in the mindset to have a productive, fulfilling day. So by setting your alarm even for just an hour earlier, you will find that you have so much more time during the day because you are doing those things before your day would normally even start. You're getting them out of the way, and whether you want to spend that time meditating, exercising, reading, listening to music, you're just gonna find such a positive change in the rest of your day. My second tip for personal development is to self-educate. So a lot of us, we graduate high school, you graduate college, and you pretty much stop your education there. But there is so much information in books, online, in podcasts to continue your education and continue your personal development. So by reading content from people you look up to, by listening to podcasts on topics that you're interested in, even just by investing 10 to 15 minutes a day doing these things, you'll find that you learn so much, you improve as a person, and it really helps you stay on track to your long-term goals. You can self-educate yourself on so many topics, whether you want to further your career, whether you want to better your relationship, whether you want to become a stronger parent. There are so many resources out there, but it is so important that you do take that time to continue to self-educate yourself on those topics that you want to be stronger in. My third tip is to make a top 5 to-do list every single day. So for me, I love to-do lists. They keep me on track, they get me excited for my day, and they make sure that I get this stuff done. But I was finding that I was making these 20 to 30 item to-do lists, and by doing that, I would look at the list and I would get all of the really easy stuff done first. And then by the time that I was ready to do the more important, harder tasks on my list, I already felt like I had been productive for the day. I crossed off enough items when in reality, I only did the really easy things. So by limiting my list to the top 5 things that I have to get done that day, I am so much more productive. I reach my goal so much quicker because I am working on those harder items that are the most important. So rather than just crossing off the really, really easy things and putting off the hard things for later, I have a small list of really important things rather than a long list of things that are semi-important. My fourth tip is to use a calendar, a planner, whether it's an online calendar or whether it's a paper calendar, to plan out your days and your week. So Sunday nights, I love to sit down. I personally use Google Calendar just because I can see it on my phone, I can see it on my computer. You know, it doesn't really matter where I am, I can still view my calendar. I like to use that to plan out everything that I have to do for that week. And I don't only plan out meetings, appointments, which is what most people put on their calendars. I like to also plan out my gym sessions, you know, when Paul and I are going on date night, stuff like that, because then I have an overview of my week. And come day to day, I will actually plan out time slots for each of those 5 things on my to-do list. And that way I don't just go through my days and weeks hoping that I get everything done that I need to do and just kind of like forgetting some things along the way. Because how many times have you said, oh, I don't need to write it down, I'm gonna remember it in my head. And then like an hour later, you're like, oh, What was that thing I was supposed to remember? My fifth tip is to use a journal. There are so many journals that you can buy that are specifically focused on personal development and reaching your goals. So these type of journals, they'll have you write out, for example, three things that you want to work on, you know, three goals that you're working on right now, and then at the end of the day, you'll do an entry where it says, what are three things that you could have improved on during that day? And you can also do this on your own simply by, in the morning, waking up, writing out three goals that you're working on, three things that you're thankful for, and then at night, coming back to all of that and writing out maybe 3 to 5 things that you could have done differently that day to help you improve in the future. So by doing these type of things, you visualize what you want on paper, you have it written down, and it actually forces you to take what's in your head where it's all jumbled and, you know, sometimes you kind of ignore it. If you have a goal, you kind of visualize it in your head, but when you're forced to write it out on paper, it really makes sure that you're putting those thoughts into sentences and you're seeing it. And for me, at least, I know that that helps me stay on track, reach my goals, and not kind of like start something and not finish it.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.